Whoa, we're on air. Good morning, AC. I'm Alec Verhagen here with your football all-star, Phoenix Music.
Good morning.
Can't believe I'm in your presence. It's an honor. For your morning announcements for this Friday the 13th. Yeah, the bad news, Phoenix, is it's Friday the 13th. The good news is it's an early release day.
Early release is good, but you know what else is good?
What's that?
Xander Miley has been selected to represent AC in this year's Hockey All-Star Game.
Now that is crazy.
Yeah, it is. This All-Star Game will be played on Wednesday, January 25th at 8:15 at York Ice.
What, you're not going to ask me if I'm going?
Are you going?
Heck yeah, I am. I love all my short kings out there.
Alrighty, admissions will be free. Congratulations to Xander Miley.
Mini-thon permission slips are due. January 25th is when those should be returned to the appropriate teachers at the high school or middle school. Did you get that turned in yet?
Soon.
Okay,
soon.
I see.
Yeah.
And if you're looking forward to bring a guest in the high school, be sure to get one of those guest form packets located in the first floor hallway by the mini-thon decorations. This also needs to be completed by the 25th. You bring anyone special?
Maybe. It's a secret.
You're that guy.
Yeah. Happy birthday to Madison Heckler, Camden Haldeman, Savannah Milan, and Nevaeh Jordan.
Wait, I think we're forgetting someone.
Who?
Jordan Seltzer.
Oh, happy birthday.
Make sure if you see him in the hallway, say happy birthday.
And give him a big hug.
He'll love that one. That's all for your morning announcements today, AC. High school students, remember to check in with your high school advisor if you're eligible for early release today at 12:20. Are you eligible?
I gotta check my grades.
Figured. Have a good weekend.
Let's go.
Welcome back to this week's episode of Dutch on the Street. I'm your host, Alex Long, and today I bring you to sunny Orlando, Florida, here at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Today, I'm going to be asking Disney patrons what they think a teacher teaches based on their name. All right. What subject do you think Miss Sobczak teaches?
Sobczak?
Yes, Miss Sobczak.
Science.
It's a good guess. She actually teaches English. What subject do you think Mr. Enders teaches?
Spanish?
We're now here at the Animal Kingdom Park. We're going to still try to find out the same question. Who am I here with?
Noah Kaplan.
Noah?
Yeah.
What subject do you think Miss Wilson teaches?
Miss Wilson. I'm gonna go with English.
Why do you think English?
Just something about it. It's giving me English vibes.
She's actually a science teacher.
That was the other one I was between, but I was thinking more English.
She's a big physics person. Big physics. What subject do you guys think Mr. Radensky teaches?
Mr. Radensky?
Yeah, Mr. Radensky.
I would have thought he was a librarian, honestly.
He's actually one of our history teachers.
I said social studies. That's why I said library, bro. Study of the books.
We're here now at the Magic Kingdom, right in front of the Haunted Mansion. I'm here with my two friends.
Sarah.
And
Susan.
So, the question is, what subject do you think Mr. Dotson teaches?
Do we need to agree or we each say one?
You can each say one.
I'm going to say algebra. History.
Both of you are wrong. He's actually a learning support teacher. He helps students out with that.
Very important position.
Very important. What class do you think Mr. Metzger teaches?
English.
Mr. Metzger?
Yeah, Mr. Metzger.
I'm gonna say metal shop.
Oh. That's a first, actually. We've never had someone say metal shop on this yet. Actually, he is our life science teacher in 9th grade, so. We're here at Disney's Contemporary Resort. What job do you think Mr. Long works at in the school?
Well, it can't be anything that involves work, so I really don't know. Just walking around checking on the kids.
Why do you think that?
Because the only thing he did when he was little was play sports. He did no work.